Bond fans, and welcome to a new video. Today, I will be speaking about dubbing. Well, the process everybody in the world knows as dubbing, but actually, it has a professional term, which is ADR. It means automatic dialogue replacement, or post-synchronization. With the recent passing of actress Nikki van der Zyl, who dubbed a lot of the Bond girls in the film series, the subject of post-synchronization, or dubbing, has come up again, and a lot of Bond fans have explored that and have rightly asked the question, why were the voices of the original actors replaced for the final version? Well, with post-synchronization, you have to understand there are several areas why producers would say, we replace the dialogue entirely. This could be unwanted sounds from the recording on the film set. It could be wind, it could be traffic, it could be animals, birds, passers-by. In the olden days, not every film set was locked down. It could also be to correct misspoken lines or improve the dramatic timing or the comedic timing of a line spoken. Also, you could replace grammar mistakes, pronunciation mistakes, or bad language, if a word ever made its way in there. Also, if a character named a product brand that should not be in there and must be removed, then it is post-synchronized. Also, films are translated into other languages for other markets, also a big area of post-synchronization. Now, this has been done a lot on the Bond films, and we will go right into the examples, but to show you how post-synchronization works, I want to give you some examples. So, imagine I would provide the voice for Dr. No, for the villain Dr. No, played by Joseph Wiseman in the very first Bond film with the same title, Dr. No. This would sound something like this.
East, west, just points of the compass, each as stupid as the other. I'm a member of Spectre.
Spectre?
Spectre. Special Executive for Counterintelligence, Terrorism, Revenge and Extortion. The four great cornerstones of power, headed by the greatest brains in the world.
Strange, isn't it? Incredibly strange. But okay, it's just for the sake of the example. And you have to be very, very careful as a voice actor when you do post-synchronization, because you have to match the lip movement. Now, I play you the same clip again, just for fun, with both voices enabled. So you will hear Joseph Wiseman's voice and you will hear my voice. Pay attention to the lip synchronization if I am in sync with Joseph Wiseman's face, and judge for yourself.
East, west, just points of the compass, each as stupid as the other. I'm a member of Spectre.
Spectre?
Spectre. Special Executive for Counterintelligence, Terrorism, Revenge and Extortion. The four great cornerstones of power, headed by the greatest brains in the world.
Well, you probably think that took me a few minutes to do, but actually it took some takes to get it right, to get the lip synchronization right. I didn't pay much attention to the color of my voice and the situation in general, so I could have done a much better job. A more prominent example, everybody of you has seen Star Wars, and everybody knows Darth Vader, one of the greatest villains in the science fiction universe. But did you know that his original voice was replaced? It was. The actor who portrayed Darth Vader, David Prowse, played all his lines, all the dialogue, but it was later decided to replace his voice. It was not menacing enough, it wasn't dark enough, and they brought in actor James Earl Jones to record the dialogue, to replace the dialogue, ADR, automated dialogue replacement. Here is a scene from Star Wars where you first see the original voice of David Prowse and then the dubbed voice by James Earl Jones.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm a member of the Imperial Senate on a diplomatic
mission. You are part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor. Take her away.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm a member of the Imperial Senate on a diplomatic mission to Alderaan.
You are part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor. Take her away!
Quite the difference, isn't it? But here you see the immediate effect of post-synchronization, and James Earl Jones's voice for Darth Vader made the character a lot more dramatic and menacing, which was exactly what the producers wanted. Another example of post-synchronization is to replace the singing voice of an actress or actor. The most prominent example here is the musical film My Fair Lady, starring the lovely Audrey Hepburn. Her original voice was replaced by singer Marnie Nixon when she sang a song. In this example, she sings the song Wouldn't It Be Lovely, and you first hear her original voice, and then you hear the replaced voice of Marnie Nixon, and you decide for yourself which one you like more.
Lots of chocolate for me to eat. Lots of cow, Mikey, lots of it. Warm face, warm hands, warm feet. I'll wound it lovely. Lots of chocolate for me to eat. Lots of cow, Mikey, lots of it. Warm face, warm hands, warm feet. I'll wound it be lovely.
In this example, the differences between the original voice and the replaced voice are not so obvious at first, but when you listen to it closely, the voice of singer Marnie Nixon has a lot more color, and you just hear that she is a singer and Audrey Hepburn was not. However, for the sake of the film, it would have probably been better to keep Audrey Hepburn's original voice, and I know a lot of film fans would have preferred that, actually, because her voice wasn't that bad. Now we come to the Bond films, where you know that many people have been dubbed male or female, and we start with Dr. No, obviously. Don't worry, I will not be replacing Dr. No's voice, but we will be looking at Eunice Gayson. British actress had her voice replaced by another British actress. Why? Well, Eunice Gayson's tone of voice was very upper class, and that's why the producers decided to make her a tiny bit lower class while still being sexy. And I will now play you two clips. The first one is Eunice Gayson's original voice heard in the Dr. No trailer, and the second one is the one we have as a release, dubbed by Nikki van der Zyl in post-synchronization. Here you go.
Now you made me miss it.
You don't miss a thing.
There. Now you made me miss it.
You don't miss a thing.
Now this was, of course, just a tiny snippet of Eunice Gayson's voice, and I would have loved to discover more. I don't know what they have in the archives. Maybe at one day we will hear her original voice. But you can clearly hear the differences between her original voice and what Nikki van der Zyl did in post-synchronization. Now let's move on to Goldfinger, where two very prominent people have been dubbed. Shirley Eaton's voice was dubbed by Nikki van der Zyl. Again, you ask yourself the question, why? Because Shirley Eaton is a British actress, and her voice was fine in a lot of other films, but she had a Cockney accent. That's what Nikki van der Zyl told me. She had a Cockney accent, and the producers wanted to tone that down and wanted to have a sexy, sultry voice, and Nikki van der Zyl could provide that. That's why you hear Nikki van der Zyl and not Shirley Eaton. There was a controversy, however, because Shirley Eaton was not always happy with having her voice replaced, and there was an episode on the anniversary of Goldfinger, the 50th anniversary of Goldfinger a couple of years back, where both ladies, Shirley Eaton and Nikki van der Zyl, were to appear at a convention together, and apparently Shirley Eaton declined, or at least she said she would not participate if Nikki van der Zyl would be there as well. And her reason for that was, she asked, what would people recognize more, the face or the voice? This can happen. Actors can be bitter about having their dialogue replaced, having their entire voice replaced, because what are you left with? You are left with your face on the screen, but you have a different voice. I can understand that for some actors this produces a problem. It certainly produced a problem for actress Andie MacDowell, if I am allowed to give you another example, of the film Greystoke, where she played the character of Jane. So let's hear what Andy McDowell has to say about having her voice replaced by actress Glenn Close.
No one ever told me there was a problem when we were shooting it. And for some reason, all of a sudden, they didn't like my voice, so they redubbed it with Glenn Close, who's a beautiful actress.
Won't be long before you're talking like the rest of us.
I hope not. I think English is so much prettier when spoken with a French accent, don't you?
No nonsense.
And so I was dead, basically, as an actor. So I had a decision I had to make, and funny enough, I started thinking about what my legacy was going to be to my grandchildren. You know, my grandmother was in this movie, and she got dubbed, but she was in this movie, or was I going to cover that up? Was I going to move on from that and really do something?
How wonderful. What animals can you do? Please, can I hear one?
Let's go back to Goldfinger. What voice would you like to hear in the original? Of course, Goldfinger. And the original voice of German actor Gert Froben is actually hidden right on our shelves in the trailer, where Bond is on the laser table, and here you hear Goldfinger speak in his original voice, which was later dubbed by actor Michael Collins, who did a splendid job of matching Gert Froben's original voice. So here you have the two. Gert Froben's original voice is the first clip you will hear, and the second one is Michael Collins.
Choose your next witticism carefully, Mr. Bond. It may be your last. Do you expect me to talk?
Choose your next witticism carefully, Mr. Bond. It may be your last.
Now let's move on to Thunderball, where we have a bit more of original dialogue. Two voices have been replaced that are significant: French actress Claudine Auger and Italian actor Adolfo Celli. They both had their voices replaced. Claudine Auger was dubbed by Nikki van der Zyl, and Adolfo Celli was dubbed by Italian actor Robert Rietti, who worked on more than one Bond film, and he also worked as the ADR director. So he directed the post-synchronization on many of the Bond films. Now, let's hear the exchange in the casino between Bond and Largo, and you will first hear Adolfo Celli's original voice and then the dubbed voice.
Any objection to ring the limit? £500, shall we say?
Too rich for me.
Count me out, too. Perhaps you'd like to take this shoe. My friend, for my... Mr.
Bond.
Oh, yes. Mr. Bond. One of my associates spoke about you.
Nothing bad, I hope.
Any objection to raise the limit? £500, shall we say?
Too big for me.
Count me out, too. Perhaps you'd like to take the shoe. My friend, what mine? Mr.
Bond.
Oh, yes. Mr. Bond. One of my associates spoke about you.
Nothing bad, I hope.
Again, you ask yourself, why was Adolfo Celli's voice replaced after the filming in post-synchronization? Because his voice seemed fine to me. Well, let's hear from Robert Rietti what he had to say about the scene.
Ah, yes, Mr. Bond. One of my associates spoke about you. Well, that was the face of Adolfo Celli in Thunderball, but the voice was not his. That was my voice on him throughout the whole film. And in fact, it was necessary because Adolfo Celli at that time spoke with a very heavy Italian accent, but so thick that it was almost like a Neapolitan speaking with an A at the end of every word. So it was necessary to dub him. And as a result of that, when people didn't realize that that was not his voice, he achieved many international films and I had a job for life.
Another scene from Thunderball with the original voice of Adolfo Celli and then the dubbed version with Robert Rietti.
Nine.
Wow. You seem to be unbeatable, Mr. Bond.
Eight.
Huit à la pompe.
Nine.
Neuf à la pompe.
You seem to be unbeatable, Mr. Bond.
Notice the subtle differences between the actors' voices? They are very subtle, and you have to listen closely to make a distinction between the two. That's how on point post-synchronization can actually be. Whether you prefer the original voice of Adolfo Celli or the dubbed voice by Robert Rietti, that's personal preference. Certainly, the producers made the decision back in 1965. And by the way, if you want to check it for yourself, this material, the original voices of Adolfo Celli and Claudine Auger, which you will hear in a moment, are taken from the documentary The Incredible World of James Bond, which is on the Thunderball DVD. So the original voices were on your shelf all the time. This next example has French actress Claudine Auger's original voice. It's the clip you see first, and the dubbed version by Nikki van der Zyl. This is the second clip. Judge for yourself.
Emilio, you promised to buy me a drink.
Soon, my dear. I'll get my money back first.
May I be allowed to buy the lady a drink?
I would appreciate that. Thank you.
Then I must pass the shoe.
Emilio, you promised to buy me a drink.
Soon, my dear. I want to get my money back first.
May I be allowed to buy the lady a drink?
I would appreciate that. Thank you.
Then I must pass the shoe.
Again, the producers made the decision to give Claudine Auger a sexy voice, a sexier voice, and remove some of her French accent. Same goes for Adolfo Celli, but we said that before.
It's going to be impossible if his leg doesn't change.
Somehow I don't think it will tonight.
It's going to be impossible if his luck doesn't change.
Somehow I don't think it will tonight.
And finally, to wrap up this video, you probably ask, why have I not heard the original voice of Ursula Andress in Dr. No? Well, because I don't have it. I'm sorry. If you stumble across an original recording of Ursula Andress's voice in Dr. No, where she actually speaks lines in Dr. No, pass it on to me. I'm pretty sure me and all the Bond fans in the world would be really grateful to hear her original voice, but there is nothing at the moment. However, right after Dr. No, Ursula Andress went to America to make a film with Elvis Presley, Fun in Acapulco. And here, this is the first American film where you can hear Ursula Andress' original voice. Remember, the Bond producers decided to replace her voice in Post-Synchronisation because she had a thick Swiss-German accent. Now, to know how that sounded to the producers, let's have a look at a clip from Fun in Acapulco, Ursula Andress and Elvis Presley. Here you go.
The king used to say that he kept the best table in the country.
The king came to your restaurant?
Our castle.
Oh.
You see, Daddy's really an amateur. He was a Grand Duke before our country went behind the Iron Curtain.
Well, then you must be some kind of a duchess or something.
Call me Maggie.
All right, Maggie.
But what my father would call you isn't setting polite company.
Why? What'd I do?
Rule of the house, finish your food.
Yeah, all right.
Ursula Andress was certainly a looker back in the day, but something was always off about her voice. And that's probably the decision why they dubbed her in Post-Synchronisation. Listen again and pay close attention to how she pronounces words like country and grand. She rolls the R in an immense way. It almost seems like it's part of the act, part of the character she's playing, but this was actually her voice.
The king used to say that he kept the best table in the country.
The king came to your restaurant?
Our castle.
Oh.
You see, Daddy's really an amateur. He was a Grand Duke before our country went behind the Iron Curtain.
Well, then you must be some kind of a duchess or something.
Call me Maggie.
All right, Maggie.
But what my father would call you isn't setting polite company.
Why? What'd I do?
Rule of the house, finish your food.
Yeah, all right.
Well, as you see, there are some advantages to Post-Synchronisation, but also disadvantages, like the original actor's voice getting lost. Maybe this also happened to French actress Carole Bouquet's original voice from For Your Eyes Only. Maybe it will never see the light of day. I am looking for it. If you know where to find it, if you have a snippet of Carole Bouquet's original voice that she provided in For Your Eyes Only, I'd be happy to listen to it, if you want me to have it, and maybe I'll make another video on that. I want to say thank you to the YouTube channel Ellis007Bond, because that's where the inspiration for this video came from, and we had a nice discussion in the comment section of one of those videos, and I hope you liked it. See you very soon. Bye-bye.